Hello there, welcome to this video. Let's see quickly how to use Graphisoft ARCHICAD 17 in a short time. Please leave us feedbacks if you find mistakes in our English. Check the Smart Index in video description to search things in detail. When you open ARCHICAD, a welcome window appears. You can create a new project or simply open an existing one. Let's create a new one. Click on New. ARCHICAD comes with a simple workspace. On the center there is your main workspace, where you are going to see, build and edit your project in progress. At the bottom there are the visualization tools. On top you have the standard bar that has a list of quick buttons to make different actions. The Info tool, used to rule the settings of the current tool used, the toolbox on the left, with the main important actions collected in groups, and, on the right, the Navigator palette, that helps you going through the different templates and parts composing your project. All these windows and palettes can be moved and closed. You can open them again, going to Window and searching inside the Toolbars and Palettes lists. While working on your project, it is very important to know what to see in your workspace. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Objects may be shown badly at first, just wait a short time for the render. It is useful the Pan button, the end one at the bottom of the workspace. When you click on it, you will move through your project, until you click once again. By default, you can see the elevations in your workspace. These are pretty useful in case you create 3D projects. Let's see how to draw 2D objects. The toolbox on the left lists all the basic templates you can add in. Documents is used to add anything that is in 2D, such as text, 2D shapes or labels. For example, let's draw a general polygon using Polyline. To start drawing, click on your workspace. The starting point is indicated through a bold cross. Then you can set the remaining settings of your object. For the polyline, after the starting point, you need to fix the next point to go on drawing. ARCHICAD helps you at doing this, showing you angles and directions of the Cartesian axis, indicating north and south directions through Y and west-east through X. You can fix the direction holding Shift down. A small white box tells you the distance from the starting point and the angle value, which is the angle respect to the x-axis. When you finish, simply click on the point just created to confirm the creation of the object. In other tools, for example the arc circle, the method changes after the starting point. In this case, the software asks you to define the radius and then the length of the arc. Each step requires a click. Then, if you change your mind, you can undo the creation of the object pressing Escape from your keyboard while drawing. To undo any mistaken action, press Ctrl and Z or use the Undo button in the standard bar above. The text tool is a little different. Set the starting point and then create an area that will be used to contain text. Choose font, size, color and style through the small dialog box above and type at the bottom. Click elsewhere to apply. To come back editing text, activate the arrow tool and double click on the text. When you use these tools, there isn't a unique way to draw an object. On top, in the info box, you can change the settings of your drawing progress. For example, if you use the polyline, you can choose the kind of contour, the color, and what to draw, a polyline or a rectangle. Mind the color or line shapes are rendered after the creation of the object. In arc circle, for example, you can choose between a circumference or an ellipse. Click on Settings dialog for more settings. There are four main points related to an object. The object vertices are always represented through a sort of OKV symbol. If you click there, you will snap to it, and the starting point of your future object will be placed exactly on it. There are the medians that indicate the intermediate point of an edge, represented as a small vertical bar. The big and red rounded point indicates the direction where an edge lays. Then, the generic point that lays on an edge or a direction is indicated through a free side symbol. Directions and trajectories in ARCHICAD are indicated through straight dashed lines in orange or blue color and are useful to follow directions different than the Cartesian axis. They can show up while drawing your object or by clicking on the big red circle seen before on straight or curved objects. Once the dashed line appears, you can fix points on such pretty easily. These trajectories are called guidelines and are shown until you decide to remove them. To do so, simply right-click on your workspace and go to Remove All Guidelines. The guidelines are tools that can be used if the guidelines icon above is enabled. Remember that guidelines are not rendered in your final project. They are just used to intersect objects' points, to make tangents, or trace lines perpendicular to the guide direction. If you need to be precise in your drawings, you can zoom in your workspace, right to avoid snappings. To insert precise values instead, digit a number while drawing an object. This will be typed inside the small white box, so you can use it to set exactly the distance from the starting point, the length, the angle of rotation, and the position respect to X, Y, and Z axes. Use the up and down arrow keys to choose which is the property to set. The properties shown do depend on the object you want to create and on the actual step you are in. Once you are done, press Enter to apply. What are the numbers used? The measurement unit in ARCHICAD is set by default and known, so you never see any unit around. To check this, go to Options, Project Preferences, and then to Working Units. Model unit is the one used in any 2D object, and angle unit for angles and directions. Let's see now how to select objects. You must select an object in order to edit it in a second step. Click on arrow in the toolbox. Click on the object interested to select it. This will be represented bold and in green color, with all its vertices and important points in black. To select more objects, simply hold Shift down and click on More objects. Otherwise, you can use a marquee area clicking outside and including all objects to be selected inside such area in gray color. Click once elsewhere to undo the selections. You can cut, copy and paste a selected object pressing Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C and Ctrl and V. When you paste, use the Enter key to apply. You can use Cut to delete fast an object drawn in the past. Then you can go on editing your object. Click on a vertex. A small dialog box will appear. This lists all the basic editings you can apply to the object, starting from the point you have just chosen. Depending on the point and on the object itself, you have different buttons. The four arrows button makes you move a node or a vertex. Use the drag button to move the object without changing anything of its shape. Click on rotate to rotate the object. Firstly choose the fixed point and then the angle. You can use mirror as well to do this. Multiply is used to set an array of the selected object. Try it out. Use angular stretch to edit the length of the arc, in case you mistaked it. Remember to use escape key to exit from editing mode. In case you click on a path, you have other buttons. Use insert new node to add a new point. Use Curve Edge to transform the straight path into a curve. You can use Edit Segment using Tangent as well for this. Use Offset Edge and Offset All Edges to edit the shape through an offset distance kept constant. Use Radial Stretch to extend or shrink an arc according to its radius value. Mind that, if you have multiple objects selected, the editings will be applied on all of them at once. There are other edit tools on the standard bar. Use the trim button to cut off parts of the line delimited by two black points. You can first activate it holding Ctrl down. The pointer will turn into a scissor. The split button is used to cut an object or a group of objects in two, without changing anything of the original shape. Select first the objects, click on a point and drag a line. The objects will be cut where this line intersects the object selected. The eye is simply used to select first the side to consider in your next step. Adjust works exactly the same, but with the difference that the objects are not splitted, but one of the two parts is completely deleted. Intersect is used to connect objects together, especially to build up angles. Just make sure to have the objects selected first, before using the button. Fillet chamfer is used to get rid of harsh vertices. There are many other ways to edit your object. Experience will guide you through. Let's see how to fill 2D objects. Activate the Fill tool on the left. To fill fast an object, simply hold the space down. Your pointer will become a wizard staff. If you click inside a closed line, it will be totally filled up. Of course, you can fill just closed lines. On top, you can adjust anything of the filling, the pattern, the background, and the shape's color and the stroke. Remember to have the filling selected to see the new settings applied. The filling just added is indeed an object on its own, that you can move and edit as seen with the other 2D objects. nothing changes. You can also add external pictures in your project. Simply enable drawing, click on your workspace and browse for your picture. Then you can manage it like a normal 2D object. Let's see how to save. You can click on the floppy disk icon or press Ctrl and S. ARCHICAD project files are saved as .pln and can be opened later anytime. To export your project, simply go to File and then to Save As, and choose the other formats available, from .jpg to .pdf. It is pretty important to select what to export. If you activate the Marquee tool, you can select the area to be exported. Just what falls inside the Marquee area will be rendered. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out the next one to go into 3D projects. Thanks for watching.